back from that commercial break. We are live at Biggie 237, the recap, and we have five ex-housemates here on the hot seat telling us just as the way we want it. And we're talking about fake brand endorsements before we went for the commercial break. And I was about to sample the opinion of Pretty Boy. So Pretty Boy, what did you really think about the endorsements? Do you really think it's fake, or some of them are really genuine, or you just don't have any opinion at all?
Well, seriously, I have no opinion because I'm not all about putting my noses into people's businesses.
That's new.
All right, that's fine. Please, can we go back to Small Bebe?
Okay. Feel free.
It's your show now.
Basha, you're actually a brand ambassador to the brand. I think, I've forgotten the name of the person or ambassador. I saw you had a brand ambassador deal. Do you share in the opinion of Chapalo and Collins, who think that these brand ambassador deals are fake? I mean, you have a brand ambassador ambassadorial deal. What do you think about that?
Some of them are actually fake.
Is yours fake?
No, it's not.
Why don't you just say the person's name?
No.
Okay.
I would like to keep it.
Okay, to yourself.
Yeah, thank you.
All right. Okay. So you think that they are fake and brand ambassador deals, but you have a real one?
Yeah,
you
do.
Two real? Okay, congratulations on that. Pretty Boy.
If you say you know something, say it.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying, that for the sake of the show.
Don't say it. No, let's forget about the show.
Yeah.
If you know something,
talk.
Say it. You're the fear person.
Talk. I'm the host here. I'm the host. Just so you know, I'm the host. So you're. Now, on a very general note, how easy or how hard was it for you guys to nominate on your first week or first 2 weeks, knowing fully well that you didn't know people that much? How? What kind of informed your nomination? I'll start with you, Collins, because you're itching to say something.
It was very, very easy. It was very
Why was
easy.
That? Why? How? Because you don't know people. How was it?
Well, in a WhatsApp group, people's attitudes were already showing a lot of snakes, hypocrites,
especially
and people who want to use emotional blame on others,
okay.
Especially the audience.
Okay.
So when we got into the house, I already nominated my five persons that are not open up for eviction.
Okay.
They are based on high.
So who did you nominate on your first week and why?
First week, Exiva was like 3 times in a row.
Okay.
But he keeps missing.
Why did you nominate him?
Exiva was fake.
Okay.
He was one of the fakest and the most hypocritical person I know.
Okay.
And most especially because I believe he did not deserve to be in that house with us. Because he just had the luck to be chosen.
So you think you deserve the house more than him?
Because based on votes,
it's a yes or no.
I deserve every bit of it.
Okay.
Based on talent and based on votes.
Okay.
But him, based on talent, maybe 30%, but based on votes, he was like number 31 or 47.
Alright.
So okay. That's an issue.
Hexival was just one. No, really just him or was it somebody else?
It started with Hexival, then it got to Brown Popsy.
Okay.
Then Kenny and that.
Alright, that's fine. Pasha Blanche. How easy was it for you to nominate people in the early weeks in your house?
It wasn't easy at all because I told everybody.
Okay.
Even though my first nomination was for some reasons, that not because I didn't like the person.
Okay.
But I would say I nominated Annabelle the first week, and that was because she was too loud. I don't like noise too much.
Okay.
And when Annabelle talks too loud,
mm-hmm.
She wants to be heard alone.
Okay.
So that was the reason why I put Wanibe up for eviction, and I nominated Kelly Nyanda too. She was too cold for my liking.
Yeah. So you don't like loud people, you don't like cold people. What do you really like?
She
nominated one person because they're loud, nominated the other person because she's cold. Like,
no, not cold as in she doesn't talk.
Okay.
Cold as in she didn't impact me in any way for 2 weeks.
Okay. Alright. Fair enough. Kitchen Boy.
Yeah, you know.
I know already. Who did you nominate? And how easy was it to nominate people in the very early weeks in the house?
You know, at the River Tokan, when you jam a man first day, if you are that social person,
yeah
you get to know more about the person just from talking with the person.
Okay.
Yeah. So actually,
you're a very good judge of character. That's what you're saying.
Yeah. Okay. So actually, I can't actually remember the people I nominated in the room, but. But the person that keeps standing on my mind that I nominated was is King Alwan.
Okay.
King Alwan.
Well, why did you know
King Alwan? King Alwan. I mean, I nominated King Alwan because King Alwan was, I mean, he was supposed to be the king, though. He was the biggest in the house. Okay. I was behaving very childish.
Okay.
Yes, he was everywhere. He was everywhere, and actually, I think I nominated Randa Kizzy too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because she was loved, as she said.
Yeah.
Yeah, she wanted to be heard alone. So, come on.
So, you think that King Alwan did not deserve the king?
No, not even for a minute.
Okay, you were more like a baby.
You can ask everybody around.
All right, that's fine. That's a good one. Now, Pretty Boy, coming to you, how easy was it for you to nominate people in the early weeks in the house?
I wasn't there in the early weeks of the house. I came in later.
Okay.
And when I came in,
Exactly. When you came in, there was still early weeks for you.
It was very, very easy because you must nominate somebody. I can't even remember the person I nominated. I just did it because it's the rule.
It's the rule of the house. Yeah. Okay. Chapal, how about you?
I think that was the most easiest as
okay. Who did you nominate and why?
First was Gada Wayne because she was so fake and seeing them, see how he's doing, they're just leaving something fake. And
okay.
I also had King Alwan, so childish,
okay.
Black leg.
Alright, that's fine. Fantastic. That brings me to my next. Okay, you also took something.
Yeah, I coming back to the board. Issue of nominating people.
Yeah.
I mean, even right up to when we left the house, Alan till today still has a brush on me.
Yeah.
You nominated him. Because I nominated him. And actually somebody told me someone that he works with directly now.
Yeah.
That he told her. Yes.
That the other person told her.
Nah. They get them, they say, eat them, they say.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what I'm trying to say. You get, yes. That he said that anybody that is close to me or anybody that is my person is automatically his enemy.
Okay.
Yeah. And we actually meet at times. We meet most at times because we live in Yaoundé together.
Okay.
Yeah. So he get away whenever I didn't meet up. I mean, David here, King Alwan and David D, for sure, one show. Mm-hmm. They will never talk to each other until we go back to the house.
Wow, so you guys have scores settled and it's not been settled.
That's what I'm saying. And he actually is the one only person
that's right. Then you should talk to him if you think he has something.
So I'm just, whether he come to this show, whether he didn't come, I'm like, wherever you are, man, I'm flat. Yeah,
okay,
I'm
flat.
That's what I'm trying to say. I want to hear him here.
I'm not accepting
that. I like some
shit. One house, guys. I think Lach has a point because if you really say that someone has a problem with you and you guys are sitting very close to each other, it's your place to meet him. Basha, I'll get to you. Have you ever tried to talk to him?
No, I knew that there would be a deal like this.
Okay, so you wanted it for the camera?
Yes. I will be good.
You want it for the camera?
Yeah, I will be good to do it. And
Basha, you wanted to
talk? So you decided to carry somebody in your heart for 1 year?
I'm not carrying him. Okay, I'm saying he's carrying me.
So you let somebody carry
you? How do you know he's carrying you when you cannot talk to him?
You let somebody carry you in your heart, in his heart for 1 year. What if he died? If you think you're mature enough, you should have gone to King Alwan and say, bro, and we need people there, you understand? So basically, let me say this and that. Let's settle this and be friends once and for all. Not you alone. No, we should not be in one show. See, and then somebody will be there, and the person will be like, and no kitchen boy will be to this table, and no king will be to this table. And then you don't greet each other.
Yo, don't blame kitchen boy because no, this is. See,
I'm not blaming kitchen boy.
No, it's not a maturity contest or something.
No,
normally, if you give me attitude or give you attitude, I don't need to talk to you to make sure that you know that this is what you said about me. Or it makes no sense. If you're avoiding me, I'll give you space too. It's simple as that. You don't
need to actually
walk to him and say, I hate you about
this. Yes, okay. Say something.
Okay, concerning kitchen boy and Adam,
yes.
We attended the ripped jeans party together. In Yaoundé.
Okay.
This is what I noticed.
Okay.
We're at the table, I'm waiting to go on stage.
Alright.
He's waiting to go on stage. He met us on that table. He just came.
Who is he?
Kitchen boy.
Okay, that's better.
Okay, now you claim that he's been holding you in his heart for almost a year, right?
Yeah. I'm saying that I don't think.
Okay, you don't think. You're saying it.
Yeah, I'm saying it.
What made you greet me And then not extend your greetings to everybody, especially Kim Adams' team.
Fake.
No, no, come on, I'm not fake.
You're fake.
Wait, come on, busy boy, you're fake.
Sorry.
Wait, let me speak.
Did you realize what you're saying?
No.
Did you actually greet?
Wait, sorry, before you continue. Come on,
did you or not extend your hand as Pretty Boy, and when you reached to Adams, then you didn't.
We were already together. These guys you are talking about here, we were already together at the poolside before I came to the table.
So did you greet King Adam, yes or no?
No, I didn't, because we already greeted Adam was the one that carried me to Vanitel's room.
Okay, he carried you. So I thought you guys.
Can I ask him a question? Yeah, no, it's not that kind of a problem. When we meet face to face, you understand that kind of thing, or
you have to just come and
see when we down. When we down, they say,
"Bro, I don't get the point."
Was that the first time you met Pretty Boy?
Anyways, ladies and gentlemen,
Pretty Boy.
After the break, we'll set you this.
That was the first time.
We'll be back after this break. Thank you.